गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास सेवेंथ। इन लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट द डेसिमल्स, होल पार्ट एंड डेसिमल पार्ट ऑफ ए फ्रैक्शन, डेसिमल प्लेसेस एंड कंपैरिजन ऑफ डेसिमल्स। Now, in this video, we will do the exercise self-practice 2G. So, question number first, write down as decimals. Write down as decimals. Question first A. First is 7/10. 7/10. Then, question number second. 800s. And then 6,000s. In the place value table, let us suppose any fraction is given, decimals is given, 57.342. Then this part just before, or we can say left to the decimal, is known as whole part, and in the right side to the decimal, that is decimal 342, this is known as decimal part. And just after the decimal, the first digit is known as tenths, then next second digit is known as hundredth, and then next one is known as thousands. So to write the 7/10 in decimal, this digit will be multiplied by 1/10, and it can be written as 0.7. Now second one is 800s, means this digit is at the second place from decimal, so it will be multiplied by 1/100, so it will be 0.08. and the question number third is 6,000s. 6,000s, so this is at the third place after decimal, so it will be multiplied by 1000, so it will be equals to decimal 006. In this way, the tenths, thousands and hundredths place digit will be multiplied by respectively. If any digit which is at tenths, it will be multiplied by 1/10. Any digit which is at the hundredths place, it will be multiplied by 1/100. And if any digit which is situated at thousandths place, will be multiplied by 1/1000. So in this way, we can convert these into fractions. Now question number second. Write down as decimal. Question number second B part. First is 6/10 plus 8/100. So 6/10 can be expressed as decimal 6 plus decimal 08. So it can be written as decimal 68. Then question number second, 3/10 plus 5/100 plus 8/1000. So if denominator containing only one zero, then we will leave one digit in numerator and put decimal. So this will be decimal 3 plus decimal 05 plus decimal 008. So on adding, it will be 358. Decimal 358. Then next question, third one. 5 plus 7/10, So 5 plus 0.7, that will be, that can be written as 5 plus 0.7. So it will be 5.7. Then next one, fourth is 20 plus 7 plus 8 upon 10 plus 5 upon 100. 8 upon 10 means it is situated at 10th place, and 5 upon 100 means it is at 100th place in decimal part. So 20 plus 7, 27 plus decimal 8 plus decimal 0.5. So it will be equals to 27.85. This will be your answer. Then next question. Fifth, 800 plus 5 plus 3 upon 10 plus 5 upon 100. So 800 plus 5, it can be written as 805 plus decimal 3 plus decimal 0.5. Now the complete number will be 80.35. So whole part is 805 and the decimal part is 0.35. Then next question, number 6th. 6th is 2 plus 5 upon 100. That is, this digit is like it at 100th place in decimal part. So 2 plus decimal 0.5. It will be equals to 2.05. Then question number 7. Next one is 6 upon 10 plus 9 upon 1000. It can be written in denominator only 10. So in numerator, just before one digit, put decimal, here 30, so 900. So it will be equals to 609. This will be your answer. Then last question, number 8. 40 plus 7 upon 100 plus 9 upon 10,000. So 40 will be as it is, it will be decimal 0.7 plus decimal 0.09. So it can be written as 40.0709. So it will be in this way. Now complete whole part is 40 and decimal part is 0.709, and the decimal places are here, since the total number of digits in decimal part are 0.709. So there are 4 decimal places. So please pause the video and note down the question. Now read the question second carefully. What is the question number second? This is very, very important exercise and lifelong. It will be very useful for you people. So please learn very carefully how the fractions are converted in decimals, how the decimals are converted in the fraction, which fraction is greater, which is less. So this is very important, right? In expanded form, question number second, first part 3.59. So first, to write in expanded form, we will know that in the given decimal number, which is the whole part and which is the fractional part or decimal part. So here this is whole part and this is fractional part. Okay. Now how many total decimal places are there? 2. Okay. So in expanded form, it can be written as 3 plus 5 upon 10 plus 9 upon 100. Then question number second. Second one is 0.007. So it can be written as 0 plus 0 upon 10 plus 0 upon 100 plus 7 upon 1000, because in decimal there are 3 digits, first zero, second is also zero, and third one is also zero. That is at the 10th place zero, 100th place is also zero, and in 1000th place is 7. So this first zero will be divided by 10, second zero will be divided by 100, and the third number, third digit will be divided by 1000, because their positions are 10th, 100th, and 1000th. Then third one is 39.2307. So this is in whole part, this is ones, this is tens. So 3 will be multiplied by 10 plus 9 will be multiplied by 1 plus 2 upon 10 plus 3 upon 100 plus 0 upon 1000 plus 7 upon 10,000. So this will be the expanded form. Then next D1 is, it was A, B, and it was C. Now D is 8.075. So whole part is only 8. So 8 plus 0 upon 10 plus 7 upon 100 plus 5 upon 1000 in the decimal part, 10th digit is 0, at the place of 100th is 7, and at the place of 1000th is 5. So 0 will be divided by 10, 7 will be divided by 100, and 5 will be divided by 1000. So please pause the video and note down the question number 2. Now question number 3, express as a fraction in simplest form. So question number 4, sorry 3, state the value of 7, value of 7 in, so first A, 73.89. Here the 7 is lies at 10th place in whole part, so the value of 7 is 7 into 10, that is 70. B, 69.71. In this decimal number, 7 is situated at 10th place. So, the value of 7 is 7 upon 10, that is decimal 7. Then question number 4, C is 2.078. In this decimal number, the 7th is lies at 100th place in decimal. So, the value of 7 is 7 upon 100, that is 0.07. And the D is 6.0027. Here the 7 is lies at 10,000th place. So the value of 7 is 7 upon 10,000. So it will be decimal 007. Please pause the video and note down the question. Now question number 4 is, express as a fraction in simplest form. So question number 4, A part, 9.08. In this decimal, after decimal there are two digits, so when we will remove the decimal, put 1 in denominator and put 2 zero after 1. So it is equals to 908 upon 100. Now it can be written as 454 divided by 50. Okay, now we can also divide by 2 once more. So this will be 25 and this will be 227. So this is the simplest form, 227 upon 25. B part, 2.075. So in decimal part there are 3 digits. So when we will remove this decimal, put 3 zero after 1. So it will be 1000. Now to write in simplest form, first of all divide by 5 in numerator and denominator. So it will be 5 4 ja 20, 5 1 ja 5 and 5 5 ja 25. And it will be equals to 200. Again we can divide by 5. So 5 8 ja 40, 5 3 ja 15 and it will be equals to 5 4 ja 20, so 40. So it will be 83 upon 40. So this is the in simplest form. Now question number C. Decimal 018. So there are 3 decimal places in decimal part. So after removing decimal, we will put 3 zero in denominator. Now here 0 is meaningless because this is left to the digit. So it will be equals to 18 upon 1000. Now on dividing by 2 in numerator and denominator, 9 upon 500. So this is the simplest form. Then next question number D. D is 1.032. So to convert in fraction, there are 3 digit after decimal. So put in denominator 1 and put 3 zero. So it will be 1032 upon 1000. Now if we divide by 2, then it will be 516 and it will be 500. Again we can divide by 2, so it will be 250. It will be equals to 258. Okay, so the simplest form is 258 upon 250. So please pause the video and note down question number 4. Now question number 5, just you have to compare the two decimal numbers. So for the comparison, we learn in theoretical portion that first we will compare the whole part, and if the whole part are different, then we will compare the decimal places, and in decimal places also first, tenth, then hundredth and then thousands. So in question number 5, just we have to compare and use the symbol less than, greater than and equality. So first question is 3.703 and 3.730. So in both the decimal numbers, the whole part is equal. So then we will observe the decimal places. So in decimal, 10th place digit is 7. Again, both are in equal. Then we will see the 100th place digit. In first decimal, 100th place digit is 0. And in second decimal, the 100th place number is 3. So here 0 is less than 3. So this decimal will be less than this decimal. That is 3.703 is less than 3.730. So in this way we will compare. Now question number 2, 1.402 and 1.4. So in fractional part we can put here 0 because 0 will be useless. See, first whole part are equal in both sides. then 10th place is also equal in this place, then this is the 0 equal in both place, here 2 and here 0. So 1.402 is greater than 1.400. Then see 9.370. Here the whole part is equal in both sides. 10th place digit is also equal. Then 100th place digit is also equal. So here we can put 0. So these two fractional number are or decimal numbers are equal. Then D, 0.407, 0.0801. Here in both the whole part is equal 0, then 10th place digit is here 4 and here 0. So this will be greater than. So in this way, if the whole part are equal, then first we will compare 10th digit. If 10th digit is equal, then we will compare 100th digit, and if 100th digit is also equal, then we will compare 1000th digit in the decimal places.